Hello students, in the last video I explained about preparation of alkyl chloride from alcohols, that is by Darzin process, and even I explained the mechanism how SOCl2 means thionyl chloride can combine with alcohol to give alkyl chloride or RCl. But pyridine, effect of pyridine means it acts as a catalyst. Pyridine is the catalyst in the Darzin process. So yesterday not explained about pyridine catalyst, how it can act as a catalyst in the reaction. Now we will study how this pyridine can act as a catalyst, or what is the action of this pyridine in the reaction mixture. Structure of pyridine. It is a heterocyclic compound. It contains lone pair of electrons of nitrogen. And these electron pair not delocalized with the benzene ring. Hence, it is a good Lewis base. Then in the reaction mixture, there is a formation of HCl. Formation of HCl. And HCl contain hydrogen plus and Cl minus. Then electron pair adds to H plus. Therefore, it can give pyridinium produce a pyridinium hydrochloride, which is salt. Therefore, product can be removed. Hence, pyridine can act as a catalyst. If you get a question in exam, explain Darzin process for the formation of alkyl chloride, and there you have to explain with pyridine. Now see the definition of Darzin process. Alcohol on heating with thionyl chloride in presence of pyridine catalyst to form alkyl chloride. This is a definition of what Darzin process. Then give some example using ethyl alcohol or propyl alcohol, isopropyl alcohol, anyone we can use to convert alcohol into alkyl chloride. But pyridine is a catalyst in Darzin process. Then remaining reactions, as I told yesterday, different methods are there. First method from alcohol, and alcohol can be converted into alkyl halide by the action of hydrogen halides. Then thionyl chloride or thionyl halides. Next, phosphorus halides. Sorry, I have covered two types, HX and SOCl2, and next is phosphorus halide. By the action of phosphorus halides, by the action of phosphorus halides, PX3 and PX5, phosphorus halides are here. PX3, PX5, phosphorus trihalide, phosphorus pentahalide. I will write a general equation for converting alcohol into alkyl halides. ROH plus PX3 gives second ROH plus PX5 gives. So these are general reactions. And PX3, PX5 function in organic reactions, they are used to replace what alcoholic OH group or hydroxyl group by hydroxyl group in organic reactions, hydroxyl group by X atom. Therefore, we get RX, here also RX. OH group replaced by X atom. OH by X. Then byproducts in the PX3. what are the byproduct. So in case of PX3, yes, we get H3PO3, and this is called phosphorus acid. It is said to be phosphorus acid, and this compound is alkyl halide. It is alkyl halide. Then balancing the equation, see here, there are 3x here, 1x multiplied by 3, then 3r here, 3r. Next 3o, 3o, 3h here, 3h, 4, equation balanced. Only in case of px3, balance the equation. px5 not necessary, because see the byproducts in the px5, OH is replaced by x, then plus byproducts in the px5, POX3 plus HX, POX3, HX, and 1X replaced. Now we get alkaloids in both the cases, but second equation involves formation of POX3, phosphorus oxyhalide, hydrogen halide. These are byproducts. Now, we will consider X equal to Cl, PCl3, PCl5. Afterwards, we will study PBr3, PBr5, PI3, PI5. But in CET papers, they can give like this direct PCl5 or PCl3 or P plus Cl2. Yes, anyone they can do. But product formed is same. It may be ROH PCl5, RCl, ROH PCl3, RCl, ROH P plus Cl2, RCl. Like this they can have. And in case of bromine, P plus Br2, iodine, P plus I2. Or they can give PI3, PBr5. But usually PBr3, PBr5. PI3, PI5, they are less stable, and hence they are prepared in situ by using red phosphorus plus bromine, red phosphorus and iodine. But anyway, by this method we can prepare alkaloids such as chloride, bromide, iodide, not fluorides. Okay, only three halides: chloride, bromide, iodide. Now we will explain using PCl5. See how the reaction occur using PCl5. But a general reaction like this, PX3, PX5. Now, examples in this case, ethyl chloride, if it is a PCl3, PCl5. And byproducts same, phosphorus acid, and here POCl3, phosphoryl chloride or phosphorus oxy trichloride. So with the possible mechanism, I'll write PCl5 reaction, ROH plus PCl5, RCl plus POCl3 plus HCl. Whenever you use PCl5, then you write compulsorily byproducts POCl3 and HCl. Let's see how these can combine. Mechanism: phosphorus Cl, 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 Cl. Structure of PCl5. So actually there are three equatorial chlorines and two axial chlorine. But yes, there are two types of bonds, two PCl bond, bond length, there is bond length higher than these two, these three bond, PCl, PCl, PCl. Anyway, in PCl5, yes, chlorine, 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 these are more electronegative than P, hence they can attract electron towards itself, and Cl become negative and phosphorus positive. So this shows phosphorus is electron deficient. It can behave as electrophile. Now it can attract electron pair. Next, ROH alcohol. ROH alcohol. So O carry electron pair, which can behave as what Lewis base. Then there is a formation of bond between O and P. Bond between O and P because of a lone pair. The electron transferred here. Then O become positive. And electron pair and P, there is a formation of bond. Next. So when it is plus, then remove H plus. And one, when there is a formation of bond, and one of the Cl move away. Cl minus H plus. H plus combine. And negative from this positive neutral. Therefore, ROP Cl, 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 Cl. ROP and 4Cl. I written 4Cl. Again, you think about the P and O. Yes, O is more energetic than P. Means O negative and P positive. Okay, again O attract electron pair. Now it is a negative with the lone pairs. Next, second time, if it lose Cl minus and there is a formation of what, plus minus with the lone pair again. Yes, there is a formation of, when it is removed, now it become plus, this become negative, and it is positive, positive, negative, again there is a formation of bond. Then we get RCl, Cl. But this Cl, this Cl can attack from the rear side. Again it follows SN2 mechanism. But about SN2, as I told in the last class, SN1 and SN2 mechanisms are there in the topic. And afterwards you come to know what are these SN1 and SN2. But when the attacking species attacks the R, from rear side of the leaving node, then it comes under SN2. Then we get RCl plus P double bond O, Cl, Cl, Cl. Now it is said to be POCl3. RCl plus RCl POCl3. So this is a possible mechanism in case of conversion of PCl5 into what, RCl. Anyway, whenever we use PCl5 in organic reactions, yes, by this method we can understand how POCl3 is formed. But all these mechanisms are not there in the syllabus. We are not getting such questions in the theory exams. Only to support this reaction, yes, we can study mechanisms. This is how I told how POCl3 obtained from PCl5. This method applicable for even phenols, ethers, wherever C dash O means carbon oxygen single bond is present, then this method you have to follow. C dash O, it may be C dash O phenolic, C dash O alcoholic, C dash O ethers. In such case, you have to apply what SN2 mechanism for reaction of PCl5 with alcohol, phenol, or ethers. Then possible questions in theory paper. What is the action of phosphorus pentachloride on ethanol? And write the equation. Phosphorus pentachloride. Ethanol, yes, you would write ethanol formula. C2H5OH. This is ethanol. React with PCl5, phosphorus pentachloride. Then it can form C2H5Cl, C2H5Cl plus POCl3 plus HCl. Now these two are common, POCl3 HCl. So this equation carry one mark and explanation one mark. Ethanol on heating with phosphorus pentachloride, it forms ethyl chloride. So that these questions we can expect. But reactivities, order of reactivities, it is a primary alcohol. We can use even secondary alcohol, tertiary alcohol. Those also react with PCl5. But order of reactivity, 3 degree greater than, 2 degree greater than 1. Right? Or tertiary alcohols are more reactive towards PCl5. Then secondary and primary. But if it is a PX3, remember always, PX3 or PCl3. If reactant is PCl3, whether we get POCl3 as a byproduct, no, you don't get POCl3. We get POCl3 only when PCl5 is used. PCl5 is used. If it is PCl3, then we get only H3PO3 plus RX. H3PO3 and RX. Then other halides like PBr3 phosphorus tribromide can give. So phosphorus tribromide, phosphorus triiodide, phosphorus pentabromide, phosphorus pentiodide. These also used to convert alcohol into alkyl halide. Alcohol into alkyl. But these are less stable or unstable. Hence they are obtained by a C2 method. Yes, by C2 method, such components are prepared. Then these attack on the alcohol to give alkyl bromides and alkyl iodides. So this about conversion of alcohol into alkyl halides by 3 reagent HX, SOCl2. And a PX3, PX5. And there is one more reaction, there is a named reaction. One can prepare only bromides, okay? Bromides. That is called HUNSDIE. CKER. HUNSDIECKER, Hunsdiecker. It is said to be Hunsdiecker or Hundaker reaction. It is said to be Hundaker reaction or Hunsdiecker reaction. So in the completed exams, you can see questions on what Hunsdiecker reaction. See how to write the equation. RCOOAZ. Yes, name of the salt, RCO, silver salt of monocarboxylic acid, react with bromine in presence of CCl4 as solvent. CCl4, because bromine dissolves in CCl4. Then this solution mixture added to silver salt of a monocarboxylic acid. Now it can be converted into what? RBr. Plus CO2 and AZBr, plus CO2 and silver bromide. Main important conversion of RCOOAZ into RBr. This one can prepare alkyl bromides by using silver salt of monocarboxylic acid and bromine in CCl4. And this reaction is known to scientist Hunsdiecker. It is said to be Hunsdiecker reaction. But remember, it is applicable only to prepare alkyl bromides, not chlorides, iodides, and fluorides. Okay. So up to this, I told how to prepare chloride and bromide. Chloride bromide means chlorides by Darzin process, chlorides by Grus process, and bromides by Hunsdiecker reaction. So means with the scientist name, means named reactions, I told how to prepare alkyl bromides. Next, second method by halogen exchange method. Method two. By halogen exchange method. By halogen exchange method. Halogen exchange method. Now see here. How to convert some halogen compounds into another type of halides. There are two named reactions. First one by Finkelstein's reaction. By Finkelstein's reaction. The important reaction. Finkelstein's reaction. Now see, what is this Finkelstein reaction? Finkelstein used alkyl halide such as RX and X equal to ClRBr. Means alkyl chloride or alkyl bromide. Because in this method we are going to prepare alkyl halides, therefore use chlorides or bromides and mix with sodium iodide or even potassium iodide. But sodium iodide, potassium iodide, it is a salt, easily soluble in water. Next. In presence of dry acetone, then RX changes into RI, plus means X replaced by I minus, RX into RI plus NaX. Plus NaX. Alkyl halide into alkyl iodide. This is called alkyl iodide. Alkyl iodide. This is alkyl chloride or alkyl bromide. Okay. Now see the importance. Sodium iodide. It is a strong nucleophile, and RX delta plus delta minus, because halogens, they are more electronegative than carbon, hence they acquire negative charge and carbon positive charge. Then I minus attacks on the R plus from again rear side, therefore it also follows same SN2 mechanism. Then when it attacks on the R, then X minus easily removed. Actually CX bond, CCR bond, CBR bond, actually strong bond, but this one I minus and triacetone, yes, it is also a protic solvent. Even we can write acetone structure CS3 CO CS3. Yes, polar bond CO and a protic. Yes, it is also a best solvent. Okay. And this solvent assists in the what only forward reaction or to get more quantity of alkyl iodide. But the main significance of Finkelstein reaction is, yes, this method is applicable to prepare alkyl iodides only alkyl iodide, not other halides. And here one type of halogen, ClRBr, yes, it is replaced by I minus. Halogen replaces halogen. Halogen replaces halogen. X equal to I return I. Hence it is said to be halogen exchange reaction. It is said to be halogen exchange reaction. Okay. Then now take examples. Let R equal to CS3. X equal to Br. R equal to C2S5. X equal to Br. Ethyl bromide or methyl bromide, ethyl chloride, anyone. Plus sodium iodide gives rise to, and solvent same acetone, and also it acts as a catalyst. Then we get CS3I plus sodium bromide provide. Then see the function of acetone, and also size of the atoms. I atom and ClBr, yes, compare ClBr and I. These two atoms smaller than I, yes. Here Ri bond, here Ri bond, here bond length less, here bond length more. Actually weak bonded compound is obtained. Then here sodium iodide, but here you get sodium bromide, sodium chloride. But such species they can combine with what? C double bond O. Now there is a formation of what? Complex type. Then there is a formation of precipitate. Means it cause dry acetone cause precipitation of halide. Dry acetone causes precipitation of sodium halide. It may be sodium chloride, sodium bromide, not sodium fluoride iodide. Hence dry acetone is used. What is the function of dry acetone in the Finkelstein reaction? So answer is what? It cause precipitation of a byproduct sodium halide such as sodium chloride or bromide, and hence they can be easily removed and leaving behind alkyl iodide. And forward reaction is favored. According to Legendre principle, forward reaction is favored to get more yield of alkyl iodide. Therefore, it can act as a what? Catalyst, and also it causes precipitation of sodium halide like chloride or bromide. So this is about Finkelstein's reaction. Now we study one more reaction, important reaction, that is called Swartz reaction. That is said to be Swartz reaction. Second also important. In a 2-mark question expected, even Finkelstein reaction 2-mark question by Swartz reaction yes, like Finkelstein reaction there is one reaction called Swartz reaction, but this method or this reaction applicable only to prepare fluorides. There is a preparation of alkyl fluoride by what? Swartz reaction. Again you take Rx and X equal to ClBr. Okay, X may be chloride or bromide. Here, not fluoride or X. Rx plus AgF. Silver fluoride, but other fluorides Hg2F2 or SbF3 or CoF2. If it is not available, even we can use such fluorides, mercurous fluoride, antimony fluoride, cobalt fluoride, silver fluoride. That's why in general I can say it is a metallic fluoride. Metallic fluoride. Okay. Alkyl halide on heating with metallic fluoride such as silver fluoride or mercurous fluoride to produce or to give RF plus AgX. RF plus AgX. So this is a alkyl fluoride. This compound is said to be alkyl halide to alkyl fluoride. Then example CS3Br, we can take one example. R equal to CS3, X equal to Br, methyl bromide. It is an example. This one general equation. But better use methyl bromide and silver fluoride. Methyl bromide react with silver fluoride to give. Silver fluoride to give CS3F plus AgBr. Yes. We can convert methyl bromide to methyl fluoride by using silver fluoride. But the silver fluoride is a covalent molecule, not ionic. And hence, we can write delta by delta minus R again polar molecule, and polar molecule and RX also polar molecule, and polar molecule reactivity is more. Easily they can combine to give alkyl fluorides. But other methods are not applicable to prepare fluorides, and we can prepare fluorides only by Schwartz reaction. It is the significance of main significance of what Schwartz reaction. By this method one can prepare only fluorides. Okay, repeat once again. How to prepare alkyl halides like chloride, bromide, iodide, fluoride. First, alkyl chloride prepared from Darzin process. Second, alkyl chloride from Grus process. And third, alkyl bromide from, that is special reaction, alkyl bromide from Hans-Dieker reaction. I am telling only scientist name. And by Hans-Dieker reaction only alkyl bromides are obtained, not other halides. And by Finkelstein reaction we can prepare alkyl iodides, chloride, bromide, iodide, last fluoride, and fluorides by what? Schwartz reaction. So special reactions over. Actually in syllabus they mentioned like this, how to prepare alkyl halides, but there are two reactions from alkanes and alkenes, those you studied in first year BUC, and revise that one because to cover CET NEET. Yes, those reactions important, and in brief I'll tell you how to convert alkane to alkyl halide and alkene to alkyl halide by applying some principles. Now you can study conversion of alkane to alkyl halides. A simple example, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. It is a butane, CH3. But this molecule contains two types of hydrogen. This is a 1-degree hydrogen, 2-degree hydrogen. Primary carbon, secondary carbon. Two types of hydrogens are there. And see, when they combine with chlorine, in presence of sunlight or diffused light, then it undergoes a free radical mechanism or free radical substitution. So it gives CH3, CH2, CHCl, CH3, and CH3, CH2, 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 Cl. One is CH2Cl, other is CHCl. Yes, two molecules combined with chlorine, it gives two different halides. First, 2-chlorobutane, and second, 1-chlorobutane. Yes, we are getting mixture of halides. Separation difficult. Hence, such methods are not preferred to prepare pure form of alkyl halides or alkyl chlorides. But one of the methods to prepare alkyl chlorides is by using alkanes. Okay, like this we can study by using even alkenes, how to convert alkene to alkyl halides. But alkane, methane, ethane, propane, butane contain, anyone you can use, and mix with chlorine or bromine in presence of sunlight, they can give different products, depend upon type of H. If the molecule contains three types of H, primary, secondary, tertiary, we get here three types of halides. As I told, their separation difficult, hence such methods are not followed in industries or in laboratories to get a pure form of chlorides. Next, from alkenes, see how to prepare alkyl halides. From alkenes. From alkenes. Alkene CH2 double bond, CH single bond, CH3. HBr, and here peroxide added. Here no peroxide. Then propene adds with hydrogen bromide, it can form CH3CHBrCS3. Here no peroxide. If peroxide added, then we get CH2BrCH2CS3. It is called 1-bromopropane. This one 2-bromopropane. Okay. Now, only in the first case, you see here, HBr, positive, negative. So, you studied the mechanism of Marconi-Cups rule. So, propene to 2-bromopropane occur by using HBr, and it follows Marconi-Cups rule. So, there you studied a negative part of the adding molecule, adds to a double bond, goes to that carbon which contain less number or least number of hydrogen atoms. Hence, Br minus get linked with CH, not at CH2. And this follows Marconi-Cups rule. And even mechanism is studied, step 1, ionization of HBr to give proton and Br minus, electrophile nucleophile. And step 2, electrophile attacks on the alkene to give 2 carbocation, primary carbocation, secondary carbocation. And carbocation stability suggests secondary carbocation more stable than primary. Therefore, the good yield, means higher yield, is 2-bromopropane, because secondary carbocation, what, CH plus, and primary carbocation, CH2 plus. So, Br minus goes to CH plus to give 2-bromopropane. So, this is in case of Marconi-Cups rule. Next, anti-Marconi-Cups rule or peroxide effect. If peroxide is added, like dibenzoyl peroxide, organic peroxide, dibenzoyl peroxide, then it causes conversion of what? Propene to 1-bromopropane. Propene to 1-bromopropane, but not 2-bromopropane, because it follows free radical mechanism. So during formation of this compound, yes, first hydrogen radical combines with propene to give primary free radical, secondary free radical there. Then Br minus attacks to secondary free radical to give what? Final product 1-bromo. H dot Br dot. That, HBr attacks to last at the end, we get answer 1-bromo, not 2-bromo. This is called peroxide. But anyway, in short, you remember, if it is peroxide and HBr, Br goes to that carbon which contains more number of H. In the absence of peroxide, Br goes to that carbon which contains less number of H. Yes, I covered different methods of preparation of alkylates from different reagents. Next, now you can study properties. There is a physical properties. Physical properties of alkylates. Now, general physical properties of organic compounds. First, physical state. Second, solubility. Third, boiling points and density. And fourth, dipole moment. All these we can study in brief. See here, physical state of the compound. So in case of alkaloids like methyl chloride, methyl bromide, ethyl chloride, they are colorless gas with sweet smell or pleasant odor. But ethyl bromide or propyl chloride, butyl iodide, butyl chloride, pentyl chloride, etc. So they are liquids with pleasant odor, but higher members, if they contain 10 carbon, 12 carbon, 18 carbon, 20 carbon, higher members, they are colorless, odorless solids. But lower member may be gas or liquid with pleasant odor, pleasant smell. There is a physical state of alkyl halides. Then solubility. See how to test solubility. So beaker is taken in which given organic compound is taken and add some amount of water. Water is added and stirred well. Using a glass rod, stir it. If the given substance or organic substance miscible with water, then we can say the given compound is soluble. But solubility of alkaloid is very, very less in water, but they are easily soluble in organic solvents. And even in some topics in first year, we studied why the compounds are soluble. Solubility of compounds in water mainly due to ionization or formation of hydrogen bond. Ionization or formation of hydrogen bond. Take example, sodium chloride, NaCl. NaCl plus water. It is soluble due to ionization. Sodium chloride or salt added to water, yes, it is easily soluble, but it gives ions Na plus and Cl minus ions. The process is called ionization. So if you say the compound is soluble, then it may undergo ionization or other one. So organic compound, example, alcohol, CH3CH2OH, this alcohol. When you add a few drops of alcohol in water, then it is easily soluble. Then solubility due to HOH, then there is a formation of hydrogen bond between water molecule and alcohol. If there is a formation of hydrogen bond between water and alcohol, then we can say there is a solubility. Means alcohol dissolves in water due to, answer is hydrogen bonding between water molecule and alcohol. Salt like NaCl soluble in water due to ionization but not due to hydrogen bond. Therefore, I told here compounds are soluble in water due to ionization or hydrogen bonding. But these two are not possible in alkyl halides because they are polar molecule and they are strongly held with the covalent bonds and they are not undergoing easily ionization and also they are not forming hydrogen bond. Hence, you can write in general they are insoluble in water. We get in one more question in theory. Isopropyl chloride insoluble in water, why? Or ethyl bromide insoluble in water, why? Then answer is ethyl bromide does not undergo ionization or it cannot form hydrogen bond with water. Hence, it is said to be insoluble in water. That type you can write answers. So this is in case of solubility. Next we can study about boiling point and density of alkaloids. Now, to explain boiling point and density, CH3Cl, CH3, here F, fluorine, bromine, iodine, yes, here alkyl group is fixed, methyl, fluoride, bromide, iodide, alkyl group is fixed, halogen change, Next, CH3, CH2, Cl. CH3, CH2, CH2, Cl. Here, 3 carbon, here, 2 carbon. Second set. First set, second set of examples. Next, one more. CH3I, CH3CH2I, CH3CH2CH2I. Here alkyl group changed and halogen fixed. Halogen fixed. Now you think about the boiling points and densities. Boiling point and densities depend upon molecular masses of alkylates. And alkyl halide boiling points densities, they are higher than corresponding hydrocarbon whose molecular masses are comparable. They are having comparable molecular masses. Okay, methyl iodide, ethyl iodide, yes, boiling points. Methyl boiling point. Now think about the boiling points. So what is boiling point? At a certain temperature, liquid boils when vapor pressure of that liquid is equal to atmospheric pressure. The temperature named as a boiling point. And in organic chemistry, see here, boiling point related to the organic compounds. If the molecular mass increase, boiling point also increase. But here even the size also you can compare. Size. As the size of the molecule increases, van der Waals force increases. And boiling point of alkaloids due to two reasons. One is dipole-dipole interactions. Second, van der Waals force or van der Waals interactions. But dipole-dipole interaction, example, CH3I. CH3I. Negative, positive, 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 negative. And there is a dipole-dipole interaction. I minus and CH3 plus. This is called a dipole-dipole interaction. So because of dipole-dipole interaction, yes, alkyl halides have high boiling point. And if size of the alkyl group is more, size, then or even halogen size increases and there is a van der Waals force. So both are responsible for the high boiling points of alkaloids when compared to hydrocarbons. Now see here about densities. Even density also same type. Higher the molecular mass, higher the density. But in case of alkaloid like methyl, ethyl, propyl, it is special case. Smaller group, actually its molecular mass is low. But density is high, therefore methyl iodide density order. Density of methyl iodide greater than ethyl iodide greater than propyl iodide, N propyl iodide. Because density equal to mass by volume, and this ratio value maximum in case of methyl iodide. Molecular mass by volume of the what molecule, then you find the ratio, this value is highest, hence for given halogen atom like iodine, if size of the alkyl group increases, density decreases, whereas boiling point increases, but density decreases, but condition iodine, and carbon number goes on increasing. Okay, this is in case of boiling point density. And one more, if size of the molecule is less, boiling point is less. So higher the size of the molecule, higher the boiling point. And here, let it be N propyl chloride and isopropyl chloride. Normal propyl chloride, isopropyl chloride. So size of isopropyl chloride is smaller than what? N propyl chloride. Therefore, boiling point of isopropyl chloride less than boiling point of normal propyl chloride because of branching. So remember the point, branching decrease the boiling point of alkaloids. Unbranched molecules, they have higher boiling point. and higher the molecular mass, higher the density, higher the boiling point. But in case of methyl, ethyl, propyl and iodides, only in such case density is more if the molecule is small. So this is about density and what boiling points. Next is dipole moment. Case of boiling points, I will repeat once again, boiling points. If you take isomeric alcohols, isomeric alkyl halides, primary alkyl halide, secondary alkyl halide, tertiary alkyl halide. Example, N-butyl chloride, then secondary butyl chloride, tertiary butyl chloride. N-butyl, secondary butyl, tertiary butyl. Yes, among the three, the lowest boiling point with respect to tertiary butyl chloride because of a highly branched molecule and size decreases. Therefore, its boiling point is least. Next, dipole moment. Dipole moment of alkyl halides C dash X C dash X. X atom, it is called halogen atom, linked with carbon which is saturated, hence it is said to be alkyl halide. Then this X atom, it can attract shared pair of electrons or bonded pair of electrons towards itself and acquires partial negative charge on carbon, partial positive charge. And this molecule is said to be polar. It is therefore, alkyl halides are said to be polar in nature. They are said to be polar in nature. Then dipole moment, there is moment of electron through sigma bond or covalent bond, yes, from one end to other end. There is less electron negative atom to more electron negative atom, there is called here dipole moment. And even mu equal to, there is a formula mu equal to q1 q2 into d, d by units that you said in chemical bonding first year. When values can be calculated, there is using charges Q1, Q2 and distance or bond length. But here, dipole moment of alkyl halides C, Cl, C, Br, C, Cl, F, Br, I. Cl, F, Br, I. Yes, this is the order according to electron gain enthalpy, based on the electron gain enthalpy. So electron gain enthalpy order of that halogenesis, Cl greater than fluorine, fluorine greater than bromine, next iodine. Therefore, the dipole moment ClFBRI, not FClBRI, correct? But usually orders are FClBRI, ICl, IBR, yeah, what? FClBRI, IBRClF. This type of water is there. But here, different. ClFBRI, therefore. Write the order of dipole moment of alkyl halides. So we can write CH3Cl greater than CH3F greater than CH3Br greater than CH3I. So this is about physical properties of alkyl halides. Now based on the what boiling points, I'll give some questions. Okay. Now only I discussed, not necessary. Questions, there is based on the boiling point, there is increasing order, decreasing order. Okay, now only I told how to write increase. If it is primary, secondary, tertiary greater tertiary less than secondary, secondary less than primary. Then in chemical properties, chemical properties of alkaloids, and this I will continue in the next video.